I recently had a case where the mother came in to see me. DCF was involved, and she couldn't understand why. And when she told me the facts, I was pretty confused myself, and I had to re-listen a couple times to get everything down and get documents and so forth to understand and plan a step-by-step plan. And what happened was that mother's son, who was 17 years old, had a lot of kids come over the house all the time. And this young man was big time into gaming. He loved to play PlayStation 4. And he had all his friends come over. So all his friends had cars. And the neighbors weren't happy with all the traffic, is what we presume. Can never prove this because it was an anonymous report to DCF. Unidentified person, or somebody I like to call a coward, because they don't want to take responsibility who they are. But the neighbors were mad at my client because there was a lot of cars, and I guess in this tawny town north of Boston on the water, people were complaining. They called the police. The police went to the home, and all they found was all these kids playing gaming. There was no drugs, no alcohol, despite the fact it was alleged that they're having big parties and everybody was smoking, booze was flowing, and none of that. It was all guys gaming, gaming, gaming. So now the question becomes, when DCF got involved because the police called them, DCF didn't really know how to go about doing the investigation, quite frankly, because they had this child who was my client's son who had good grades, was doing well in school, never been involved with the law, never had any problems with anybody or anyone. The school said he was a good kid, wasn't a troublemaker, wasn't causing fights. He played football, and he just said he loves the game, and so does all his friends. So what were they doing wrong? A bunch of kids got together at somebody's house? Where do we draw the lines? Next time, we'll be saying there's too many kids on a ball field playing ball. This is crazy. The neighbors never backed off and made reported calls, we later found out, according to the police log, according to all the Tara tapes, according to what was reported to the police, which the police didn't want to turn over to us, but we got the records anyways. And we showed DCF that this was malicious, ill intent by the neighbors, that these anonymous reporters were not so much anonymous anymore. And all the kids were doing was just getting together and playing video games. I mean, how much harmless could that be? And the mother said to me, at least I know where my kid was. He wasn't out on the streets. He wasn't out drinking or drugging or doing something stupid. He was playing harmless video games with his friends. And when DCF caught wind of this, and the investigators saw all the records and all the documents and all the evidence, we made a job so easy. And there was only one conclusion you could reach, that there was no drugs for kids under the age of 21. There was no naked women or alcohol flowing. All these kids were doing was simply gaming, PlayStation 4, and harmless. And I think as a parent, everybody would want their kids to be safe playing with their friends. And mother just shook her head when all was said and all was done. She's like, I can't believe. They said I was neglectful. Well, that case went south, much to the credit of the department investigator, who took an open mind, looked at everything, wasn't spooked by the fact the police were involved, and reached the right and final conclusion to overturn and reverse the allegation of neglect, that there was no marijuana, there was no drugs, and that my client, the mother, and her son weren't doing anything that was against the law. We're against DCF for child abuse and neglect.